What is this, Tommy's quick one for you? Story of my life. I take her home. Right, I drive all night. We keep her warm inside.
Please welcome to the official Vodafone Big Top 40. He's a dear friend of ours. Make some noise for Liam Payne.
Yes! Hello.
Liam's in the building.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was a lovely welcome.
Hi, Payne, friend.
True story though. Very true story.
It's a true story. Always so good to see you. You too, mate. You too. You're looking very, very well.
So are you.
So are you.
How's things going,
mate?
You're looking mighty well as well. Sorry, just to include you in our little bromance over here.
I
was just saying, I think it's mad that we have known each other nearly 10 years.
It is 10 years. Yes, it's probably really longer 10 years, actually.
No, because I was 14 when we met.
2008, you and I auditioned for The X Factor at the same time. Oh, yeah, like in a couple of months, it'll be 10 years.
10 years.
This is our 10-year anniversary.
Oh, guys.
This is emotional, man.
What's your favourite thing about Marv?
He's just the most welcoming man. I love him. He's the best, man.
10 years is a long time,
10 years is a very long time.
Like, seriously.
Like, we've done well. It's a relationship.
We're still here.
Like, showbiz,
I want you to like a tweet or a like on our anniversary. That's what I expect.
All right, we'll mark the date.
I know you're a romantic man.
Payne, listen, you're back, okay? You got a brand new tune. You're smashing them out. The minute, man, we love it.
Thank you.
This one's called Familiar. Tell us about it. What's going on?
So Familiar is kind of that song where, like, when you're out somewhere and you find someone really attractive and you're like, I really want to get to know them. And this is that song of like the chase, which I think everyone's kind of been through. And that's a lot about what my, you know, album and kind of music kind of leads to. Is a little bit naughty sometimes. But you're it's like kind of like the chase, and that's sometimes for people the most exciting part of a relationship for a lot of people. So this is that moment of like, you know, can I just get to know you a little bit?
Absolutely.
Love that.
Which is having the confidence to do so, which is it's hard. That's hard to do.
It is.
It's
you teamed
easy.
Up with J Balvin on this one, though.
Yes.
He's a pretty big deal in the Latin world.
Oh, my goodness. He's amazing. I mean, and he's such a nice guy. And the thing is, because we're from such different cultures, we don't really realise what was, you know, where we are in with each other, which is quite funny, which actually makes our relationship better, because there's no egos or any nuts like that. I mean, I'm not like that anyway, but still, it's like, you know, he's exactly the same. And it's so funny, we sat down for dinner, we went to that Salt Bae restaurant.
No, you did not.
I remember seeing that on your Instagram.
The best thing about Salt Bae's restaurant,
it's in Miami,
is
right?
Pepper Bae. He's the hidden secret. He's the hidden gem.
What, does he just come in after?
Oh my god, he's just like, he's ripping off Salt Bae. He's like, yes, I'm Pepper Bae, like, comes in his thing and he's whatever. It was hilarious.
Does he wear sunglasses as well?
No, but the other guy just doesn't really talk. It's quite funny, actually. Yeah, he just walks around and just like...
He doesn't need to talk though, does he?
He's like, look, I am the... I don't know what... Yeah, it's the crazy thing, but we love seeing a man chop up a bit of meat.
Absolutely.
That's what we're here for.
He loves chopping meat.
So we were in there, and I got to say, the food's really good, even if the restaurant wasn't part of like chopping up meat or whatever. The restaurant itself is really good.
The restaurant's not called Salt Bae though, is it?
But there's not many. It's called... you're asking now. It begins with an N.
Okay.
It's his name.
Like that.
Yeah, it should be called
Something like that. Okay. But anyway, so we sat down and we figured we found the same things funny. We had a similar humour, whatever. We kind of had a similar look about each other. We liked the same sort of thing. So
you and J Balvin or Salt Bae?
No, not me and Salt Bae. He's like, I like knives and meat. I'm like, well, I mean, I like the meat part, but I'm not sure about that. And we just discovered we like the same things, me and Jay, to Jim Balvin, to put it in the story. And so he was like, you know, what have you got coming out? Showed him the song. He's like, I really like that. This is going to be massive. Da, 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 da. And I was like, oh, you couldn't mess around. It's still a work in progress. Yeah. And the song was completely English before he went on it. And then, like, I like the fact that he didn't just go insert rap here comes the rap, like a traditional thing of like middle eight, boom, there's a rapper.
Yeah.
It was like he went over the whole different songs and cut verses out and did different things. And I was like, he just kept everything in. I loved it. I just thought he did a great job. Yeah. So he's really talented at what he does. And he's just got a real great flow about him that no one else has got right now.
And it's that summer vibe, man. It's the perfect time, isn't it? So we kind of got Salt Bae to thank for Liam Payne and J Balvin getting together.
He's made some serious music here.
Love that.
You had Bella Thorne in the last video. Any mega babes in this one?
Mega babes in this one? Not really. This video is more of like a party kind of vibe that we went for. We've gone back over like the way you make me feel kind of vibes, like with those streets and different things. And then obviously like we had a bit in the club, and then we did like, you know, when Justin Timberlake and NSYNC did that video where they're dancing on the cars.
Oh,
we did like a little bit of a thing in a car, in this car park, with these different cars around and stuff, just to take it back to some old school stuff that I, you know, it's all the stuff
90s.
I watched when I was growing up. It's kind of what's influenced me to make my thing. So it's kind of a little bit like that. So
did you do a Kendrick Lamar and smash the car up? or did you like just take
no,
it?
Honestly, just
they didn't do a very, good job of smashing that car up.
Well, because it's too expensive, you have to keep it within a.
They could have like scored the windscreen or something before they started, so that it would just smash on impact.
Yeah,
a bit of movie magic.
Yeah.
You know, if I'm going to go crazy on a car, I'm going Nutty Barry on it.
It's very true. Looking forward to seeing the video, mate. Payne, can you stick around for a bit so we can see what your song charts a bit later?
Let's do it.
Liam Payne, everyone. Yes. All right. So our next song comes from, it's Liam Payne. Liam, congratulations.
Hey.
Amazing, mate. Yes.
Thank you.
So
thank you.
Good. How does that feel, bro?
Amazing. Thank you so much. You know, I mean, it's just crazy. I'm so excited.
It's brilliant, man. As we said, you're smashing out the tunes in a minute. How are you going to celebrate this one being such a high new entry on the official Vodafone Big Top 40?
Oh, I mean, I've got no idea. I don't know. I'm going to go. I'll probably just go home with the family. I'll probably end up cooking dinner or something. I'm living like this Hannah Montana lifestyle at the minute, where I'm home with my dad and da-da-da-da-da. And then when I'm out, I'm like, wait.
Miley Cyrus when you're out.
I'm like, yeah, exactly. She's got Miley Cyrus ain't got nothing on my Hannah Montana. It's the best.
That's all
complete
all
switch worlds from baby sick to being sick.
Yeah. Perfect. That's all good, mate. Liam, we're getting so many questions from your fans. Marsha has got in touch, Sam. When are we going to get the album and what can you tell us about it?
The album will be out, I hope, summertime. I'm the same as everybody else, but obviously I'm getting told to have a bit of patience with my label, because the thing is, when you start this and I'm starting out as a new artist, you want people to hear you on songs, so different producers will kind of go, you know what, I can hear him doing this. And that's what has happened quite a lot so far in the way I've got a lot of my different records. So I'm glad I was so patient. The album's coming out soon, and it's a bit like a big playlist, and I've got a lot of different features on there because I think people are used to hearing many voices, you know, on a playlist. If you turn something on your phone, or you know, when you're listening to the radio, there's so many different things coming, and people have gotten used to the idea of that now. And I think that's why the album's kind of dying out a little bit, which is sad. So I'm trying to bring that back with, you know, having as many collaborations as I can and not being afraid to share it out a little bit and be in that sense of the word rather than being, this is all about me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want it to be all about me, if I'm honest. I
want it to
be a big thing, big party, you know.
It's your album.
Kind of thing.
It's got to be a bit about you.
It's a little bit about me. Now, there's many songs.
There's a good mix,
but I like the fact that it's shared out in that sense, and that I've got to collaborate with some of the most, you know, amazing artists. And then, yeah, we'll see what happens.
What are you going to call it? A little bit about me?
This is a little bit about me.
10% me, 9% you.
Amelia said, last time you're on the show, you talked about Paw Patrol. Please do a version of the theme tune for my 4-year-old son, will you?
Paw Patrol?
Yeah.
Which one's Paw Patrol? I talked about PJ Masks.
That was the one.
And my manager, I just couldn't believe it. In the middle of a meeting, we're in this big office. It's like the head office of the building. And like, I'm sat there and we were just talking about these different tunes that come on. Like, because I was saying, like, my son only responds to the theme tune after. He's like, yeah, I'm bored of this now. Yeah, SpongeBob SquarePants, I'll have a bounce that. Yeah, why not? Oh, you're boring now. He's very selective. We did the funniest thing the other day. I don't know if you've experienced this, but there's a certain type of notes that you can sing where, so say I sing something else to him, I'll sing familiar to him, he like starts bouncing in his high chair, he's like buzzing off it. But then if I go, he gets really sad.
He just starts crying.
It's the weirdest thing.
God,
and me and Chess were sat there. I was like, this is the craziest thing. Like, he loves music, so why? Yeah. But it's not like he's like, it hurts my ears. I'm like, Dad, you're rubbish at singing, shush. It's more like it hurts him internally, because it takes him a while. I'll like go, and he just goes, oh my goodness. He just starts crying.
That's so weird.
He's a softy.
Don't hit him with a high note.
Little soft lad. Don't hit him with a falsie.
That's it. This one's from Tilly Liam, saying that we know you do a very good Tom Hardy impression. Can you do some 1D lyrics as Tom? Because that would make my dreams come true.
1D, I can't even think of any 1D lyrics now.
It's been a while.
Why is this Tommy's quick one for you? Story of my life. I take her home. Right, I drive all night. Keep her warm inside. It's frozen.
There you go. Perfect. Love that. Liam, thank you so much for coming in on the show today, mate. Can you introduce your new tune for us on the official Vodafone Big Top 40?
This is my brand new single with J Balvin. This is called Familiar.
Yes, Liam Payne, everyone. Woo! Yeah!